Hey, what is up everyone? My name is Redick and welcome to my nightmare, practically, because I'm gonna show you guys the PlayStation 1 games that I grew up with. So I wanna share my experience with you. So if you have any experience similar to mine, where you're like, oh yeah, I had the same experience as that you had, or perhaps a different section of the game, please let me know in the comment section below. Because I wanna know. And the reason why I came on this idea was I got a lot of PlayStation 1 games and I just thought to myself, just a random thought, I thought it would be a great video to make for my YouTube channel because I've always been a scaredy cat. And I thought to myself, you know what, how cool would it be to like revisit certain games that scared the living poo-poo out of me and talk about it, like what actually scared me. So without further ado, let's jump in. So for the first one that I want to talk about is the Resident Evil 3 cinematic. And now you might say, what the hell? Like how? Why? So there's this scene, I don't know, I don't even know why, but it made me almost not want to try the game as a kid, and I never completed it as a kid as well because I was stuck on the battery thing. I don't know why, and of course the Nemesis, but like the Nemesis wasn't as scary for me.
Stars.
Than this. So there is a scene where you have like these zombies coming out of the elevator. I don't know, whatever, soldiers, I forgot the name of it. They're like defending themselves, they're like shooting and shit. And there's a scene where like a pale zombie with blonde hair is like gently like moving towards them, you know? And it's that section, I don't know why, it doesn't make any sense to me now, but as a kid, whenever I saw that, the way that he limped towards the camera, trying like to bite them, some of it scared me because you could see that the bullets were not doing anything to it. And that really got to me. But anyway, that particular scene of Resident Evil 3 scared the living daylights out of me. It gave me nightmares for, I don't know, a week or so. It was like, I knew that zombies would go down, even with like shooting them in the face and whatnot, when, you know, when you watch like Dawn of the Dead or something, or like George Romero, or like the Zack Snyder 2004 one, Dawn of the Dead, where it was just like one bullet and they're dead. I mean, that's what I saw later on, but as a kid when I grew up with it, that scared me. So yeah, there you go. So the second one that I want to talk about, and I'm actually listening to it right now as I'm like recording, is the ambience sound of Resident Evil 2. So if you're standing outside the Raccoon City, or I believe it's like on the second floor where you can like navigate from like the second floor to the first floor, you have like a staircase where you play as Claire or Leon, and if you stand there like for just a sec, you hear this is what I'm playing now. It's like the ambient sound of the zombies. And it's like the moaning, or like, you know, they want to eat flesh or something. Like, that was the things that I was thinking about as a kid. They want to eat flesh. It's echoing through the streets of Raccoon City. And you're standing there as a police officer, you know, as Leon S. Kennedy. Or Claire Redfield, who was looking, of course, for her brother, Chris. And someone that always got to me. So whenever I went out there to grab, like, green or red herbs, I did that as quickly as possible. So I would click it, you know, like mix them together, get like mixed herbs, and go straight back in. Because inside I didn't hear the ambience, so I felt more relieved. But somehow this always got to me, and I don't know why. It doesn't make any sense to me at least, but it just really got to me as a kid. It's not that I had like particularly always nightmares about it, but there were like certain moments or so, like during the night, and I would have like my window open, I would think about it, and that would terrify the crap out of me. Because I felt like, oh, a zombie is coming, or like a zombie is like moaning, and then, you know, like I was kind of like making up a scenario in my head. Absolutely terrifying. Terrifying myself as a kid was just, I was really good at that, you know? But yeah, this one really stuck with me, even now. Now I kind of look at it from a different perspective when I listen to it, but at the time it was terrifying. So this one, Evil Dead, Hail to the King. First of all, I don't even know why I own it originally in the PS1. But I guess at the time it kind of looked really cool because you had like Ash Williams standing there with his chainsaw arm, and you saw like the cabin in the background, and it was really appealing to see the green and the black like in combination. The cinematic was horrifying because I remember, this is actually a topic that I want to talk about some other time, but I remember also watching the movie The Evil Dead as a kid. That was really absolutely 100% terrifying. So if you guys want to have a video on that or like on my, you know, the movies that scared me, let me know in the comment section below. But I remember really fondly that I got this game and I put it in and I saw the cinematic. I was like, uh-oh. You know, because at the time my English was really bad, so I was like, Evil Dead, okay, it has the word dead in it, but I had no clue, right? I was way too young. Then my parents even let me get that game is beyond me. I don't even know why, but that's beyond the point. So I played it, and I remember really distinctly what really got to me was after the cinematic, I was already traumatized by, first of all, by the way Ash spoke about, you know, Evil Dead and the Necronomicon, or I believe the Necronomicon Ex Mortis means the Book of the Dead. You know, like these were all words that I had no clue what it meant, but it sounded really scary to me with like the imagery and stuff. And then you had the hand, the cut off hand that was like walking in the cinematic, and then you had the possession of like his girlfriend in the game. And then, you know, you started. I had no clue what to do. So, I was always stuck in a cabin. And whenever I went outside, you had, like, these sort of, like, ghostly figures that really scared me. The ambient sound, of course. And just the overall feel of the game was just really terrifying. I had no clue what to do. I didn't know where to go. I was scared of, like, every corner that I took on that game. Whether I opened the door or not, I was afraid to even click on the door. It was the whole aesthetic of the whole Evil Dead game. Now when I look back on it, I think it looks really cool. The camera angle, the fixed camera angle, and like the way it looks, I think it's great. But at the time, it was horrifying. How old was I? Probably the same with the other games, probably around 7 or 8, I believe. Because like all these games already came out. You know, so it wasn't like that they were new. So that, like, it would take a few years before the other one would come out. These were all games that already came out. It was just a matter of me, I don't know. I didn't even know why I got my hands on them in the first place. But horrifying experience. Like I said, I never ventured too far off of the... off of the cabin. Because of all these sort of like ghostly creatures that popped up each year, I would almost die, go back to the cabin. Game over, you know, rinse and repeat. Then I got really bored of it, but it was also really scary. Like, I liked Ash, even as a kid, I liked him, you know, like as a playable character, but like, I just couldn't deal with the whole horrifying, terrifying feeling that it gave me, which is actually for a PS1 game, I think that's really good if a game is able to create that. But as a kid, you know, you get scared of anything, and you even get scared of your own shadow, so just imagine playing a game like this. It's horrible. If I may say so myself, I find this one really laughable and kind of silly. Dino Crisis. And the first one, obviously. You get thrown in there with, like, Regina and her companions. And it was particularly the cinematic scene, or actually there were two scenes, but the cinematic scene was the first one, actually. Where you had like the dino, like the T-Rex, I believe it was in the dark, it was like chasing someone. I don't know why, but it really got to me. Then he also ate him. absolutely horrifying as a kid. The sound the T-Rex made. I can't do it, of course. Like I'm not a dinosaur, so I won't even try it out. But the sound and like, you know, like after dinner, it's like late at night, it's like 6 p.m. or something. To have witnessed that as a kid is it just stood by me. The other scene that I want to talk about is. I don't know even how I got through the game, because I thought the game is really difficult with its key cards and stuff like that. And I remember it was like a jump scare. Like, I got up the second floor, and there was like this room, and I went in there, and there was like the T-Rex came back, and he put his head through through the glass, like the glass pane window, and it was like such a massive jump scare for me. And I believe I also died instantly or something. I don't know if it was low health, but I thought it was almost like a like sort of like button mash moment, but it wasn't. But that's just kind of how I remembered it back then. But I guess it was low in health because he grabbed me and I was dead. That terrified me as a kid. Like, I was afraid that like every time that now I would like enter the room, like the T-Rex would like pop his head in and like try to eat me. So like that's kind of like what it did to me in my child brain. Really funny now when I look back at it. But back then, yeah, I was absolutely tense. Like I you probably think that I was like a kid that was like on cocaine because my eyes were like really big, like a Looney Tune, you know, like a cartoon character. Because that's how sweaty and terrified I was. But still, I tried to play. Although it will give me endless nightmares, but I would still try. You guys know exactly what I'm going to talk about. You guys can see it behind me. I believe this one gave me like such a hiccup, such a jump scare. I believe I couldn't sleep for a month because I did not know. Like, this was like my first experience with Resident Evil, where like I didn't know. I believe it was at night as well. I looked at the you know, like at the disc and whatnot, and I looked at the whole picture. I was like, oh, that looks cool, like a dude shooting things. But I didn't really remember. Like I said, I couldn't read English or any of that, so I was just looking at it, and I was like, oh, this looks fun. You know, I'm not sure. I should like actually look this up. Maybe I'm wrong, because I'm not remembering it correctly. But maybe he was on the back, on the backside, you know, like of the not of the disc, but like of the thing. I'm not 100% sure though, but he could be on the backside. I don't know, whatever. I'm not 100% sure, but I thought I saw it kind of like. It was not the original. It was just like a printed out paper, you know, like on an A4, and then people would like put it, you know, like inside a box and whatnot. So it was really low quality, so I couldn't really see it. There was like a lot of pixels and whatnot, but it kind of looked like it, but I wasn't really sure. I don't know if that makes sense. But anyway, so I played the game. I believe I played as Chris. Yeah, I don't think I went with Jill. I think my first one was Chris. And he had like this open cinematic, which was live action. Which I was like, oh, cool, it looks great, you know? Like, cool graphics. you know, or like, you were... I thought I was going to watch a movie or something. And then like, you would like play through it. And then you would have like these cutscenes of like live action. But it didn't happen. It was just the intro. So the intro was already scary enough with like the first person, you know. I believe there was like this moment where you had like you were like in this dock and you were like go towards like one of those members of STARS, and then you would like jump on him. He was like that. And then you also had the other intro, which was with Chris Redfield. It's really iconic now, when you have like, the camera like really zooming in on his face, right? And then he screams, and then you see like, Resident Evil, right? So like, I remember playing as Chris, and then you have Barry, and then after Barry you have like the door, and you go through the door. And you hear like flesh eating, right? You hear like, ch-ch-ch. I was like, what the heck is going on? Like, what the fuck? So, you know, like you walk there, and I walk really slow, you know? I didn't hold, I believe it was square to hold in order to run. I already figured that out, I think, back then with my tiny little child brain. So I walked there, and then, like, this cinematic plays, you know? Absolutely. Like, what's the most terrifying thing for me with this zombie? It's not that he's only bald, but that he also has like blue eyes. And look at that. It's still sort of terrifying to me now. Like, it almost does not look like a zombie. It looks like a stone corpse or something because it's so gray. But it's this, in particular, this scene. The way that it looks at you, like, so dead in its eyes and just thinking, like, meat, right? Because this one is with Jill. But anyway, standing up and then, like, the whole, like... right? I couldn't sleep. Honestly, I couldn't sleep for a month. Maybe even longer, but I believe it was a month that I had nightmares of this creature, like, hunting me in my dreams. Trying to find me, trying to eat me. It's horrible. Absolutely horrible. Yeah, this one, it still sticks with me today. Alone in the Dark. A new nightmare. One of my favorite games now, and also with the Alone in the Dark remake. Which is, I guess it's kind of okay. If you guys want me to make a review on that, by the way, just let me know in the comment section. Because I got a few things to say about that in particular. But the reason why I like Alone in the Dark, The New Nightmare was just not because you got like two different characters, but they also have two different distinct stories. It's kind of like interwoven. But anyway, I digress. That's not what we're going to talk about. But I just really like this game now. But back then, as a kid, I remember it was one of my first illegal games, let's just say it like that, because I kind of like flashed my PS1, so I was able to play burnt games, you know, like that you would burn on a CD. Or DVD, I believe. Or was it CDs? No, it was CDs, yeah. It was one of those, because I wasn't able to buy this one, and down the road, years later, when I wasn't scared of this game anymore, I wasn't able to get it, you know, like on a disc, or like on an original disc. So anyway, I was happy that I got it back then. Anyway, I digress for a second time. What really scared the living poo-poo out of me this game was the zombies. There's one particular hall. We have like these zombies that are like moaning, and they're like really not just only terrifying, but like they also like make really weird moaning sounds. Not like a particular zombies like in Resident Evil. I thought these ones were even worse or scarier. Sickly was the ambience, especially when you first start out as Cornby. And with when you play as Eileen as well, with like the lady, like, you know, you start on the rooftop and you go to like, you know, like you go into the window, there's like this old lady. There's like this sort of ambient sound, it was really terrifying. And the lady was also blind. The grandma that was like laying in the bed, and she was talking about gibberish, about like Indian burial grounds and shit like that. It was really terrifying. Cornby, on the other hand, it was like the fixed angle. It was really terrifying to me. It was one particular one that really stood out to me. It was like in the window, and he would look down and he saw Cornby, he could move him. Somehow that feeling of you being like inside the house and you had like Cornby to move around back and forth. This is really terrifying. And it was only one scene, because after that it doesn't happen again, which I find it really unfortunate. But back then, it was super terrifying, because I never experienced that. And it's dark and everything as well in this game. Puzzles, and you gotta move back and forth, you have the ambient sound, and... The thing that also really scared me was the swamp. With, like, the, where the plane crashed, in the cinematic. And the graveyard, of course, because the graveyard was just absolutely horrifying in every way. But just the mansion itself, the ambient, the dialogue, the music, terrifying. Now I look back on it, it's really good. And I never completed the game as a child, by the way, because it was too difficult. As an adult, I've completed four times, five times. I don't know, I still really like the game. But back then, horrible, horrifying, nightmare fuel for me as a kid. Just every doorstep, I thought something was gonna attack me. Yeah, and then when I played as Eileen as well, like, with her you only have like a flashlight in the beginning. So that was kind of creepy because I couldn't shoot it. I couldn't shoot the beast and whatnot. And they were scared of the light, because only the dark scared of light, that makes sense to me. But Great game, by the way. One of the best PS1 games in my opinion. But back then, yeah. Nightmare Fuel. I'm not sure if I had like continuous nightmares about it, or that I was like a week or so that I could not sleep. I can't really remember that, but like when I played it as a kid, it really, like, the ambient sound, I would, like, even after shutting off the PlayStation, I would still hear it in my head. That's how terrifying I was of this particular game as well. Dracula 2, The Last Sanctuary. I do not know why I owned this game originally yet again on the PS1. But I never got further than after this cutscene, you get into like the house, and the whole like now when I look back at it, I love how the house looks abandoned, creepy, and it's like, you know, you have to like click and move around and like do puzzles, so it's not like a WASD or like a tank control type of game. It's a really old game, and I think for like a PlayStation game, it's actually really interesting that these games sort of existed. But anyway, I digress. So the thing that really scared me was this cinematic of Jonathan Harker trying to save Mina and then like escaping Dracula. But because this is part two, I never played part one, so I was really confused. I was like, huh, it starts really weird, right? What really scared me was the box art as well, like seeing Dracula, absolutely horrible. Then when I saw the cinematic, and you see like the kind of like the mouse move, which I think at the time was really nicely done actually. Now that I look back at it, now that I watched it myself. Nothing can stop me. Because that didn't happen until like, I was like 2005, 2010, something like that, early 2000s, where they actually tried to like do like this, but even emotions, but whatever. That scared me. Dracula, no eyebrows, pale face, like his whole demeanor and aesthetic was just terrifying. Then when I played the game and I saw the house, I had to figure out how to get into the house. So I got to the point where I got into the house, and then there was this sort of like vampire esque boss, or like this sort of bat, but then like really big. And I remember there was like a timer, like a red bar timer. And I could never figure it out. And because I couldn't figure it out, I died. It was a cinematic, I believe, or so that you died, and then I had to do everything over again. So eventually I just quit. But somehow I never got past it because I didn't know what to do. I tried to listen, you know, like through like the little papers that you grab, like transcripts or something. I just couldn't figure it out. I thought it was a really difficult game. After rewatching some of the gameplay, by the way, I still think it's a really difficult game for like how the way that you have to figure things out and whatnot. So, kudos to everybody who was able to complete part two and also part one. But yeah, I never got past the house because I was always terrified of that beast. I was always terrified of like Dracula showing up. Although it was like daytime, because I knew that even back then I knew vampires would only come out at night. But it was like, I saw the creature, like, what the fuck is that? You know, so I tried to move around, do things. I couldn't figure it out as a kid. But this one really scared me, and it still lingers sometimes. When I watch like a horror movie or something that has something to do with like vampires. Sometimes I kind of remember this one. It really put like a big impression on me, actually. Especially, like I said, the whole aesthetic of the game. The cinematics look really fucking creepy, in my opinion. There was a sort of atmosphere, sort of like ambiance that just really got to me every time. Even though when I rewatch it, it's not scary. It's just, of course, you look at it from a different perspective now, like, it's not scary, but it still looks weird. So yeah, that was my experience with, like, Dracula 2, The Last Sanctuary. Yeah, absolutely horrible. Nightmare fuel, really, as a kid, honestly. This one, I think, is gonna be the biggest surprise on the entire list. Legacy of Kain, Soul Reaver. I might say, what the... how does that scare you? Yet again, vampires, right? Like, I really had... Zombies and vampires are like my Achilles heel. Like, terrifying. Anyway, the reason being for this one is not particularly the first part of the cinematic. It was like the part where Razia would like fall down and turn into this soul reaver, from a vampire to like a soul reaver. And there's a part of the cinematic where you see that he completely like deteriorates because he's been like falling for thousands of years. At the time, I didn't know that. But what really stood out to me was like his jaw was missing. And whenever I was playing the game, even back then, I could not really like, you had to like change time, you had to like do something, and like you were like in the, let's just say the new time, and there was like a past time, you had to like switch between them. That was really difficult for me, but the thing that really stood out to me was the, like I never really got to like a first boss, like I killed some enemies and that was it, because I got completely stuck, but what stood out to me was like the jaw. Like he would like grab his scarf or like pull it down, and he would like suck in the souls of the monsters or like the creatures or vampire-ish creatures that you would like kill. And that really stood out to me. I don't know why, but it was really scary to me when he like pulled down his scarf and you saw like, you know, like the fangs on his teeth, but there was like no lower jaw. And for the fact that he had blue skin, with his hair, I thought it did not make any sense at the time. You know, I thought it was scary. I was like, oh, why do they do that, right? And like, why did they give him like white eyes? Why doesn't he have like eyes like myself? So like the whole aesthetic of Raziel was just really scary to me. And I really can't wait for a remake. And that's it now. But back then I was absolutely terrified of him. Like absolutely terrified. It was almost as bad as Ape Odyssey actually. Couldn't deal with it. Now, I don't know about you, but Ape's Odyssey, because I just named it when I was doing like the Soul Reaver one, and it's not even on my list that I wrote down on like what games scared me. But now that I think about it, Ape's Odyssey, that thing was like nightmare fuel. Ape's voice, the aesthetic of Oddworld. The creatures haunting you, but it was mainly just like this cinematic that I'm playing here behind me. I don't know what it was about Abe. Yeah, like I said, it was the voice and the character itself, the design of like the ponytail. My name was Abe. I was Employee of the Year. And now at that meet, it was like the voice, the gluckens. And then when I was actually playing the game, it was terrifying, the way that it looked. The funny thing was, of course, was like the farting and stuff. And then he would like whistle, like, then you could like save other Mudokons. That was cool, but I never got too far into the game, I believe, back then. I believe I got into like the second part, or it was with the, I believe I got to the part where you were, like riding the mount. I believe that's to the point where I got, and then later on, of course, when I got older, I replayed it and I completed the game. Although I must say the last section is really difficult, but back then my English was a bit better, so I understood that like the Mudokons were turned into like popsicles or like meat popsicles. And that was all really terrifying. But like I said, it was the music, it was Ape. That was just so terrifying to me. I believe I couldn't sleep for some time because he sounded like a frog. And then sometimes, like at summer eves, summer nights, you would not just hear crickets, but you would also hear like frogs, right?
Okay.
So whenever I would hear like a frog, I would think of Ape. I would think of him. I thought he was going to come and get me or something, kill me, I don't know, whatever, like do stuff to me. That's how terrifying Ape was. Now I think he's a cool character, but back then he was just the most disgusting and abomination of a creature that I could ever think of. He was just terrifying, honestly. He could, because he even looked sort of like a frog, like you know, the skin color and everything. Horrible. Get me out of here. Horrible. In a good, and now in a good, but back then, oh god, I did not even dare to touch it, and even like the whole box art of Abe's Odyssey, and maybe boot up the game, you see like him saying hello, right? That was even scary to me, let alone then to like play the actual video game. No, I didn't. Like I said, I played it, tried it. Eventually, I just kind of got accustomed to it, but in the beginning, I was absolutely terrified of him. Even till this day, I'm not 100% sure how I should pronounce this game. Is it called Medieval? I still don't know how to pronounce it. But anyway, Sir Daniel, the skeleton who brought back to life because of like a magic spell gone wrong. Now, I played the remaster. I own it on the PS4. I completely completed it. Fun game now. Back then, horrible. Because what I fully remember of the original classic one, the one that I'm playing behind me, was the eye and the whole aesthetic of the face. It felt too large for the character at the time. Playing a skeleton as a hero, it didn't make any sense to me back then, because yet again my English wasn't good enough in order to understand what was happening with the story. Like, why am I playing a knight that's a skeleton? It didn't make any sense. Where's his skin? Why isn't he growing his skin, right? It's actually a really funny game. It can be a bit difficult at times at certain sections. But back then, I didn't even get further than the first level, I believe. The first or second level at best. Didn't know what to do. I thought it was really creepy. The whole aesthetic of the game yet again. The vibe that it gave me, the atmosphere, the whole... the other creatures. And it felt almost like a graveyard I was playing in. I didn't like it. And the cinematic was terrifying to me. I don't know what it is with these old classic cinematics, but sometimes even when you look back at it, like when I look at it now, it kind of reminds me of like Tim Burton, of like the way that they like structured the houses. It's sort of Tim Burton-ish, but it's the creatures, man. Like, look at them. It's absolutely terrifying even to look at. But like I said, overall, I was a really scaredy cat back in the day. This one, I had to put this one on my list because it was nightmare fuel as well at the time. Absolutely. I still find it a little bit weird looking now when I look at it. I mean, I like it. I think it's cool because it's a completely unique. And I'm glad that they kept that in the remaster of Medieval, I believe that's how you pronounce it. But overall, yeah, no, I couldn't get further than this. That was basically my list. Now you might say, like, where's Silent Hill? Did you ever play Silent Hill? I never owned it on my PlayStation. What about Parasite Eve? Never played it. Clock Tower? Never played it. There are, like, a lot of horror games out there. Many horror games that I've played now. Like, now I've played Silent Hill 1, 2, 3, and 4. And stuff, but at the time as a kid I didn't, and that was the whole point of this video, right? To like talk about what I played as a kid and what scared me as a kid, what gave me nightmare, what was my nightmare fuel. These were the games that I remember. If you guys want, I can make a part 2 if I can remember a few more games. I do not think so. It wasn't particularly going to be like a top 9 list or top 10. I just kind of went with the flow of like what I remembered from the top of my head. These were the games that I remember that really scared the living shit out of me. And there's one particular thing that actually scared me. There was a demo. There was this demo, a PlayStation demo, where you could play a T-Rex, where you could be underwater. And particularly the one underwater scared me because you could play as a stingray. And I always thought that a whale, like a... Jaws, but like a great white would like pop in and try to eat you or something. I don't know why. I had a wild imagination as a kid, but if I can find it, I will play a clip of it. But I remember that. Yeah, I was usually, if I would boot up the demo for whatever reason I had, it was that actually. It was the whole T-Rex and the stingray in the blue water. I don't know why it scared me, but it scared me. Yeah, because I don't like water anyway, so maybe that's why. But yeah, that's the video. If you guys enjoyed it, I put on some timestamps as well, so you guys can click which video, or like, sorry, which game that you might find interesting or that you want to know my opinion on. So yeah, thank you so much. Be sure to subscribe if you want to see more of these types of videos, or perhaps particularly a certain level that scared me, even as an adult. For instance, I could talk about Amnesia, The Dark Descent, with the grunt. If you want that, leave a comment down below about that as well. And then I'll see you guys next time. So thank you, and have a great rest of your day.